What is up, guys? Today we'll be making a two-color square lanyard, and this should be the end result. For this project, you will need Paracord. You have here Urban Camo, Gecko, Safety Orange, and Blue Camo. For this project, I will be using the Gecko and some black. You'll need a knife or scissors. This is a Swiss Army knife, genuine one. This one is the Tinker Deluxe, and it has the scissors and the knife. Choose the one that works best for you. I'll be choosing the scissors because they are sharp and I can cut it when I need it, in the place that I need it without imperfections. So this will give me the best results. After that, you need a lighter to burn the ends of the paracord. Of course, you can use other types of cordage, but paracord is the best. Making a lanyard for your knife is extremely useful. It helps take your knife out of your pocket and in an emergency situation, for example, these paracord braces, you carry them because they carry a lot of rope and you carry them in your wrists without bothering you. So when you need rope, you have it. In any emergency situation, in a survival situation, or in your everyday necessity, if you need a rope, you have it in your wrist. The same way the lanyard works, the same way you carry rope with it. And to make this lanyard, you need to know that the 3 inches, which is 7 centimeters of paracord, to make the lanyard, you will need 2 times 3 feet, which is the two colors, black and the green. So 2 times 3 feet, which is the same thing as 2 times 30 centimeters. That's what we need to do this project. We have all of our tools, the paracord cuts to the length that I want. Don't forget to use a ruler to check the measurements. What you need to do right now to start this is to choose what color will be the loop behind. I want the black to be part of the loop that will allow my lanyard to be attached to this knife, for example. Let's start. Remember, I want the black to be the loop. So my loop color, the loop that supports the lanyard, I want it to be the black. So remember, the black, find that the middle point, which is here. The black needs to be the horizontal one and under the green. Now find the middle point. If it's not perfect, it's okay, guys. The middle point right there, and lay that on top. Now follow me. Grab the right side, put it to the left. Grab the left, put it to the right, like this. Make this shape, just like this. The top part needs to go over this one in the hole. Same thing with the bar. Goes over this one in that hole right there. Now just tie everything. Not too much, guys. This is very important, because once you get this part done, it should be easy. This is the worst. It's the start. Once you're happy with that, don't over tie it. See, looks really nice right now. As you can see here in the back, the black is on top, so that will be our loop as I planned. That's very important. Do the same thing. The left goes to the right goes to the left. So this bottom one needs to go over in like this, and this one goes over in and tie it again. Don't over tie it because we want to do the loop. Just give it the basic shape. This one will be really, really beautiful, guys. These colors are awesome. Turn everything around, and as you can see, the top one is the black. That will be our loop. Just pull it. until you're happy with the size. This one should be enough for me. Now you can tie it to 100%. This first knot won't be for perfect, guys, because you have the loop. You can do this without the loop, but well, you have the loop already, so it's just one thing that you won't have to do later. Now just keep on going. The right goes to the left goes to the right, like this. Try to do this shape, it helps a lot. Again, you need to go over and in, over and in, tie it. From now on, you should give it a really good squeeze, because you want to maintain that square shape. Let's do the same thing, the right goes to the left goes to the right, this one goes over and in, tie everything. As you can see, it's getting faster because the paracord is starting to get that square shape like we have here. Our last time, guys, before I finish this up, and the right goes to the left goes to the right. We just make a shape like this, goes over and in, over and in. Just tie it. Here's the final result. In my opinion, it looks awesome. It's much better than one color and I really like it. Now what's missing is to grab your scissors or your knife, trim those tips right there and burn them. Please guys, give me a thumbs up if this video helps you out and add it to your favorites so you can try this project later or recommend it to someone, or even if you want to be extra cool for me, just share it on your Facebook, on your Twitter. Well, really hope this helped you guys, and I'll be back with some more paracord projects, fishing videos, or even some bushcraft or knife reviews soon. And this is a fishing lure that I made myself. So expect a video on this one too. Take care, guys.